Let us now study about compound microscope. In previous section, we already studied about simple microscope. And here we can see a simple microscope has limitations on its magnifying power. So for higher magnifications, we use compound microscope. We can write about it that it uses two lenses called objective and eyepiece. So, due to the successive magnification of two lenses, magnifying power of a compound microscope is much higher compared to a simple microscope. The lens, which we term as objective, is closer to object, and eyepiece is the one which is closer to the observer's eye. Let's look on the optical setup. Here we use an objective convex lens which is having a focal length FO, and at some distance from this we place another lens which is the eyepiece lens having focal length FE, and this is the side from where observer will have a look into the system. And on the left hand side of this objective lens we place an object, say it is of height H, and is located at a distance u from the objective lens. Now, just to produce a real image of this object, real inverted image, as object is placed very close to the objective, its focal length has to be very small. So, in general, we can say in compound microscope, the focal length of objective is less compared to that of eyepiece, and the small, as well as this objective we consider is a small aperture lens. Its aperture is also taken to be very small because generally microscope is used to magnify the angular magnification of very small sized objects. So if aperture of objective is taken large, the light rays which are falling onto the lens from object which are on the edges or marginal rays will not be paraxial. So due to spherical aberrations, the image will not be clear. So its aperture is generally taken very small. Now, in this situation, if we produce an image, here we can see there is a point where an image is produced by the objective lens, which is an inverted image, say this is of height H prime, which will act as an object for eyepiece, and from eyepiece, the light rays are passing from this object, and these are passing in such a way that these are producing an image somewhere at this point, or you can say this is the image which is produced, or it can be seen by the observer's eye. Now, in this situation here, we can see this is the final image, say it is of height H double prime, which is seen by the eye. So, this can be seen clearly if it is obtained at a distance of a near point from the eye, because we consider eye to be situated very close to the eyepiece lens. Or it is also possible that if this image is produced such a way that final image is produced at infinity, then I will be able to see the final image which is highly magnified and in relaxed state. Now say if this distance is taken as UE and this is the distance we are taking as V, which is the image distance for the objective as this is the image produced by the objective lens. So here if we use lens formula for objective lens, then here we can write this 1 by V minus 1 by U is 1 by F, and here we can use the object distance is minus U, image distance is plus V, and the focal length we consider as plus F naught. So, on substituting the values here, you can see the value of V we are getting is UF naught by U minus F naught. Now, in this situation, if we find out the magnification by objective lens, then this magnification by objective lens we can directly write as the image is inverted, we can consider it as a negative magnification. And for a simple lens, magnification is V by U, so this we write as minus V by U. Or it is written as negative of, when we substitute the value of V, it is F naught by U minus F naught. And if we talk about magnification by eyepiece, then magnification by eyepiece in this situation, as the image is produced at a distance D, we already studied in case of simple microscope, the magnification is given as 1 plus D by F. So in this situation, the magnification produced here, we can directly write as 1 plus D by FE. This is the magnification produced by the eyepiece if final image is obtained at least distance of distinct vision or the near point. So total magnifying power of a compound microscope, if we calculate this magnifying power of compound microscope at the image which is produced at near point, can be written as the product of these two magnification, as these are successive magnification. So this can be written as negative of V by U multiplied by 1 plus D by FE. This for image produced at near point. Similarly, if we talk about magnifying power of compound microscope for image produced at infinity, then in that situation we can simply state for image produced at far point, that is at infinite point, we can directly write in this situation the value of UE will be equals to FE. Because when this intermediate image is obtained at a distance of focal length from the eyepiece length, the final image will be at infinity. In that situation also, the magnification by objective will remain same. But that of eyepiece, we have studied in the previous section that this is equals to D by FE. And this is for M infinity, and this was used for M at a distance D in previous section we have studied. So now this total magnifying power of a compound microscope for image produced at infinity can be given as minus V by U multiplied by D by FE. This is the relation we use. And these results, you can also remember that this first part is the magnification produced by the objective, and the second part is the magnification produced by the eyepiece, which is considered here as a simple microscope or a simple converging lens. So these two terms we are using from the result of simple microscope, and these two terms are the magnification produced by the objective.